Hello, my lovelies. Today's video is going to be a, I guess, wear test or competition between the Maybelline Fit Me. This is the Shine Free and Balance Foundation Stick and the e.l.f. Moisturizing Foundation Stick. I recently bought this one if you watched my e.l.f. One Brand tutorial, and I actually really like this one and I want to try some more, and I've used a lot of Maybelline products, so I thought that theirs would be a good one to try. I have used it a couple times, but I used it with other new products and I wasn't really sure how it was wearing. So what I'm going to do is put the e.l.f. one on one half of my face and the Maybelline one on the other half. We'll use the same concealer, powder, everything, and we will see which one lasts longer. So first thing I'm going to do is prime my face using the e.l.f. Tone Adjusting Primer. Alright, we're going to go ahead and start with the e.l.f. Foundation Stick. And color-wise, I think they're pretty similar. Let's go ahead and compare that. The Maybelline one is maybe slightly cooler toned, but they both match me pretty well, so I'm not too concerned about that. We're going to go ahead and just put the e.l.f. one on this side of my face, and then I'll tell you how it applied, and then we'll do the Maybelline side. Alright, so there is the e.l.f. side done. I really love this foundation. It applies super easily. I think this is probably the fastest foundation I can put on. It blends so easy, and I love using it with just a damp beauty blender. Pretty good coverage. This is one coat. I did add a little bit over these spots, but it still didn't really cover them, so I'll probably just dab some concealer over that. But all in all, it looks good. It just has a satin finish, and is one of my favorites right now, so I'm excited to see how the Maybelline one stands up. This is supposed to be shine free, and I think it's supposed to go on kind of matte. I think there's a little core in it. You probably can't tell because I've smudged it, but there's a little core in it that's supposed to be shine free, so it is supposed to be more of a matte foundation. So let's go ahead and apply this one. I'm just going to use a damp beauty blender again. And we'll just apply this to the other side of my face. Alright, so there is both sides done. They look pretty much the same. Both feel they kind of dry to a powder-like finish. They're not super tacky or anything. The Maybelline one does apply a little bit more dry. I feel like you have to really work harder to get it spread out and even, and there were a few places where I did have to go over it again where my redness was still showing through, which it doesn't really with the e.l.f. one. All in all, they both feel pretty similar right now though. I'll have to look up the price differences for you guys, but I remember right. The e.l.f. one was either, I can't say it was more than like $4, and the Maybelline one was $7, I believe. But anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and do the rest of my makeup. And yeah, I'll update you guys later. Alright guys, I am here to do just a little over 2 hours update for you guys. I don't know how well you're going to be able to see. Both sides are basically looking the same. No real change so far, except that the Maybelline side is creasing a little bit. by my nose. Other than that, both sides look the same for the most part. I'm gonna grab a mirror so I can look up closer and make sure. Concealer is creased on both sides, but concealer always does that to me. It is just a little bit worse on the Maybelline side though. Not too big of a deal, not too much of a difference yet. I do have to go to work, so once I get home I will be updating you guys, and then I'll probably wait a couple more hours after that and give you kind of a final update and opinion. So I'll see you soon! Alright guys, I am back to do another update on how the foundations are doing. It has now been 8 hours? 8 hours. since I've had my makeup on. Both of them are still doing pretty well. They're both starting to come up right in this area right here, which always happens for me because I have oily skin. And the Maybelline side has faded on this little spot right here, which I don't know if you guys can see super well, but I have a little spot right there. And then Elf side's still looking pretty good. Chin's a little worn on both sides from me leaning on my hand. Both kind of creased around their nose. Maybelline side is just a little bit worse. And forehead looks good overall. So pretty even so far. I feel like the Maybelline has maybe faded a teeny bit more, just in this area where my bronzer is. I feel like the Elf side is still, sorry, the sun is like super strong right now. I feel like the Elf side is still just a little bit more defined. It hasn't quite like faded as much there as the Maybelline side. But yeah, I will probably update you guys one more time before I take my makeup off for the night. But yeah, hopefully, I don't know, I want to say hopefully the Elf one will last longer because it's more inexpensive, but when I looked, I went back to try and look up this product on their website and I couldn't find it. I don't know if they stopped making it or not, in which case it would be better for the Maybelline one to be better if they aren't making it anymore. But I guess, that was weird. I guess we'll see. Yeah, I'll talk to you guys in a bit. That's not good. Alright guys, I'm here to do my final update on the Maybelline and e.l.f. foundations. It has almost been 12 hours. We're like 20 minutes away from being 12 hours, so we're just gonna count it as 12 hours. And I'm sorry, I'm gonna take my glasses off so you guys can see. I'm not that extremely blind. both sides honestly look pretty even. Whoa! What are you doing? Both sides look pretty even. I was laying on the side of my face in bed. But it doesn't seem to... Loki! Loke! What are you doing? It's not frisky time. Do you want to come say hi? Can you see him? Loke! Loki! Loki, Loki! Okay. So, both sides look pretty much the same. For the most part, the Elf one just kind of rubbed off around the nose, whereas the Maybelline one kind of dried and cracked. Neither of them are really great. In the short amount of time I did have my glasses on, the Maybelline one pulled up the foundation and left, like, you know when you wear sunglasses and it leaves a little, like, imprint of the nose? I don't even know what it's called, guys. the part where the glasses sit on your nose. So I had my glasses on for maybe like 5 minutes now. And the Maybelline one already kind of gathered in that little shape. Forehead looks about the same, honestly. The bronzer maybe looks a teeny bit better on the e.l.f. side. Like, I think there's a little bit more bronzer still left on the Maybelline cheek side, but I was laying in bed on this side of my face. As far as how it looks on the skin, I mean, by 12 hours of wear, you're not expecting your foundation to look amazing, so I'm not expecting it to be great. They're both a little bit patchy and almost look dry, even though they're really oily, just on the set, the under eye kind of area where you do your concealer. All in all, I'd say they're pretty comparable. They seem to wear pretty much the same. Application wise, I think the e.l.f. one is definitely better. It's, first of all, it's a bigger stick. Like, if you look, it's like, I'm gonna put my glasses back on. I get a lot of reflection off my lighting. But it's basically double the size of the Maybelline one, which makes it a lot easier to apply with the Maybelline one. I felt like I had to keep drawing more lines than I do with this one. This one covers more space, and I feel like the product itself also spreads out easier. I don't know, I mean, I set both sides, same powder, same concealer, everything. I don't feel like this one was like stayed matte longer. I feel like they wore basically the same. So if the e.l.f. one is still available, this is the one that I would recommend to you guys. Obviously every product's gonna be different for everyone. I have combination skin, so like when I wash my skin, it's super super dry and I have to moisturize it, but by the end of the day it's really oily. So like the idea of a matte foundation seems good to me, but then when I wear it, it usually makes my skin like have dry patches, and then when it oils, it just looks bad. But I mean, out of the two, I think I definitely reach for the e.l.f. one more. I mean, the Maybelline one is good, but I definitely like the e.l.f. one better. So, yeah, I mean, very comparable in quality, price. Like I said, I wasn't able to find the e.l.f. one on the website, so I can't tell you how much it was. The Maybelline one, I believe, was $7 or $8, which I'm pretty sure, I want to say that this foundation was like $1 or $2. This one was definitely $7, $8-ish. So if you can find this one, I would recommend going for this one. And when I run out of this one, hopefully I'll be able to find it. If not, maybe I'll have another favorite foundation stick by then. But I don't think I would ever repurchase the Maybelline one. I just don't really like it. I don't like the blending. I don't love how it feels on the skin. I don't know. I feel like I'm just sitting here repeating myself. I think that's everything for this video. Alright, thank you guys so much for watching. Be sure to like and subscribe if you want to see more videos from me. Be sure to let me know in the comments down below if you've tried either of these products and which ones you've preferred, or let me know if there's another stick foundation that you use that you just love or that you prefer over these ones specifically. Yeah, thanks again so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.